really tell God thank you for those songs of praise. We thank God for allowing us to be able to walk through the doors one more time. And we praise him and thank him for all the great and wonderful things that he has done. I want to tell God thank you for bringing me into the knowledge of the truth. Yes. Lord knows. Lord knows. Lord knows. Yes. I was lost. But I fooled myself. Yes. I thought I knew the way. Yes. But he told me, listen. Yes. And when I listened, it changed things for me. Yes. If you never hear the truth, you can never be set free. I'm not talking about the truth that theological seminaries give to you. I'm talking about the truth of the Word of God. Yes. The truth of the Word of God opened my blind eyes to who I was. I found out I'm the son of a preacher, son of preachers, the brother of preachers. But I found out I was on my way to hell. And I want to tell God thank you. That on that ride that day, he told me, listen. And the reason I believe it was him, because see, the devil wouldn't have told me, listen. Religion would have told me, fight. Fight to stay wrong. But I want to tell God thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I heard listen. And when we listen, we can hear through the word of God to the real creature that we are. I thank God and honor God just for bringing us all out one more time. We thank God for the excitement. We thank God for Brother Eddie as he came back from the ushers meeting. He came out saying, hallelujah. We thank God for Sister Yvette. She walked in praising God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank God for William being back, William Ponder. Thank God for them being back. Listen, people, we're in a place where Jehovah lives. He is alive, and I'm thankful for that. We're going to have testimony service on today. I'm going to ask each one that's going to testify to please be mindful of each other. And after which, I'm going to open us in a word of prayer, and I'm going to have our devotional leaders, Adrian and Sarah, to come forth, and they're going to lead us through that portion of our service on today. Let us stand, those of you that are able. Thank you, Father. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Father God, as we come before your throne this afternoon, God, we're asking you to wash us. And God, we're asking, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you lead, guide, and direct us as we go into our service. We invite you to come, God, and have your way. Bless each testimony, bless each song. And God, we want to tell you thank you for the foundation that you have laid, a foundation where wretched sinners can come and see who they are. God, do everything you do today. Do it all to your glory and to your honor. We thank you, we praise you, just for allowing us to live to see one more day. Continue to keep watch over us, and God, continue to watch over our children. And we want to tell you thank you for what you've given us through Psalm 91, your divine protection, those precious promises that you've given to your children. Lead us, bless us, shine upon us. In Jesus' name we pray and I thank you. Amen. Amen. Let's welcome Sarah and Adrian.
So good that God has allowed us to come back into his house one more time. We thank God so much for all of our beautiful visitors that we have with us today. And I most certainly always want to thank God for having my special brother here. So good. And I mean that in a special way. That is a special brother. And we thank God for him. We thank God so much for what God is doing in our house. Yeah. And right now I'm talking about in the house of God. Yeah. How God is walking and taking some of us back down lover's lane. Yeah. What is lover's lane? Those things that God himself have done in our lives. Yeah. And I'm so glad to be in a place where God will allow a young man, whoever you are, space to repent. He'll give you a little time to make the right choice. And I find out you can't make right choices on your own. God has to be working on the inside to cause you to step out of yourself and come to Him. I'm so glad to be here. Wouldn't want to be no.
That's right. Praise up.
Somebody may think that's something small, but it's a jungle out there. And we are in the house of safety. If I can twist myself like a can, I believe that wouldn't be enough to express how glad I am to be in this house. We don't want to be nowhere else. And I mean that from the inside. We thank God for being here.
Here, thank God so much for my brother's opening. Yeah. I am in full agreement. Yeah. I thank God for the power of remembrance. Yeah. Don't you know God said, wake up, baby, one more time this week. Yeah. The devil, because of you, will take you down a blind alley. Yeah. Don't you know your emotions, your feelings can take you down a blind alley. Yeah. God said, I need everything to be in my will. Yeah. I need everything. I want all of you, Sarah. Yeah. He loved me just that much. He said, I want all of you. Woo. I'm so glad for the Spirit of God turning around and saying, it's Sarah here. It's good when somebody comes looking for you. And guess what? When he calls your name, he's looking for a response. The right response. You got to meet him. God, I am a sinner. I want to meet you. Prodigal son, he came running to his son. But guess what? The son came running too. I said, Lord, I thank you for my revival on this week. God said, I didn't just say wake up almost 11 years ago. I'm saying wake up every day to yourself. And I am glad. I'm going to sing a short portion of this song. How great is our God? Don't you know he was great to wake me up? He's so great. He's so great. I told somebody this week, I'd be like a shriveled up raisin without my praise. I got to have it. I got to have it. I got to have it. It's like medicine to me, y'all. How great is our God? Sing to the heavens. You're so great, God. One day I will see. You're so great. You're so great. Oh, how great is our God. So great to come rescue a girl like me. Oh, we'll see how great
is his name.
Oh, he has a name above all names.
Name above all names. How great is our God.
Thank you for being great, God.
Thank you.
That'll cause you to not look at what other folks think. Yeah. I'm not myself in half. Because I know about the message. It brings your flesh down. But guess what it does? It brings the soul alive. Bring the soul alive. We praise you, God. We not celebrating today about new cars and new houses. We are celebrating God is causing the inside to live. Sometimes you don't know what to do with God. His goodness is so good. I remember when I played football. We used to have to do drills. Look like your feet have to go so fast. But God, goodness, I don't believe my feet can keep up with me. Because God is God. God is so good. He is so good. He is so good. Ooh. The praises. The praises. Praise the baby. Tell on yourself, baby. Tell on yourself. Hey. Hey, God. Praise God. Praise God. Hey. Hey. We're going to turn it over to Minister Brent. This house. Alive. How you doing? By telling on yourself. You alive. In the midst of so much darkness, you'll be glad to be alive. Alive in Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We certainly tell God thank you for those testimonies. We thank God for what he's doing for our brother. Not only is he chopping him down, there are others as well that he's chopping on. It's a blessing to be chopped by God. If God can chop you, shout. Because if he can't chop you, something's wrong. Amen. We praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
That brother's happy with the method God used on him. If God can chop on you, he can put your flesh down, but he can revive that soul. We thank God for what he's done. We thank God for all the wonderful testimonies. We honor God for our young people and what God continues to do for them. And at this time, we're in the hands of the ushers. Thank you, Father. Father God, as we come, God, we ask that you watch us. And God, we want to tell you thank you for this offering that we have received. And God, we want to tell you thank you for each giver. And Father God, we want to tell you thank you for just looking down upon us and enable us, God, to be here one more time. We ask, God, your continued blessings upon each and every one of us. And as you bless us, God, we ask that you bless this offering and enable it to do all that you choose for it to do and accomplish. We thank you for it. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Certainly tell God thank you for our prayer hour. Thank God for this time in our service. And thank God for what he has been able to do and accomplish during this time in his service. Many years ago, prayer was prayed in Lee County, asking God to bring in the young people. That's when he broke me free and loose from the bowels of Babylon so I can come to Albany, Georgia. And I want to tell him thank you. Let us look to the Lord, those you're able to, along with me as we go before his throne on today. Watch us, Heavenly Father. Cleanse us, God, and purify us as we come before your throne. Father God, in the name of Jesus, as I come, as we come, Lord, we want to tell you thank you for your patience and your long suffering. Thank you for your kindness towards me. Thank you for your kindness towards us. I was destined for hell's flame, but you wouldn't let it be. And I want to tell you thank you. God, we come before your throne this afternoon, looking to you, the Almighty, Jehovah, to bless our prayer list. And God, we're asking that you look down from heaven upon the names that are written here on this prayer list. We just had the names read. You know everybody's situation. You know everybody's need. You know the condition of everyone's heart. And Father, in Jesus' name, we're looking to you to bless each person whose name is written here on our prayer list. We ask you, Father, as you go by your power and by your spirit, whatever you can do upon your arrival, God, bless them. I know that you can do the impossible because all things you are possible. If you can come and get a man out of religion that's been there all his life, if you can bring one out of the crack house and take the taste straight out of his mouth, If you can cause a fornicator to quit fornicating, God, there's nothing that you cannot do. So we're looking to you, the Almighty God, Jehovah, to bless these individuals whose name is written here on our prayer list. If salvation is needed, God, lead them to a place where there's a gateway for heaven, as you led me to a place where I can find out the truth of the Word of God. Do all these things for your honor and, God, for your glory, and we will forever praise you. In Jesus' mighty name I pray and I thank you. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Will your heart and soul say yes? Will your spirit still say yes? There is more that I require of thee. So will your heart and soul say yes? Now will your heart and soul say yes? Yes. Now will your spirit still say yes? If I told you what I really need from thee, will your spirit still say yes? So just say, God is saying, open up your heart and tell the Lord yes. Say yes. Yeah, 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 yes. Say, I'll obey Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I won't stray, Jesus. 'Cause this time I've made up in my mind. I've made up in my mind. My soul says yes. My heart says yes. My mind says yes. Yes. My soul says yes. Yes. more that I require of thee. God is saying, there is more that I require of thee. So much more. There is more. So much more. He said, I'm here to guide you, to lead you. Just look to me. Don't look to yourself. Don't think that you know. Don't trust your will, but trust my will. There is more. So much more. He said, I want to take you high.
Is coming from Psalms 8. Psalms 8, we're going to start reading we're going to read verses 3 and 4. Psalms 8, 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 verse 3, reads as follows. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained, verse 4, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? I want to tell God thank you that he came and stopped by to visit me. Praise God for the reading of his word. Back at the hands of the choir.
I call you holy, your name is holy, you are so holy to me. Righteous you are, and righteous you'll be. Thank you, Lord, for being you. Yeah. I call you awesome, God. That's your name. You are so awesome. Came and rescued me. Your name is awesome. Awesome you are. You'll be.
I call you Savior, Lord. That's your name. You are the Savior. Jesus is your name. Your name is Savior. Savior, you are. Savior, you'll be. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Yeah, yeah. I call you all that.
I call you all that.
You are. You have been all that. And so much more to this wretched girl. That's your name. Righteous, the ruler, redeemer, savior, a sinner, the king, a king, Lord, a Lord, the one who came and died for me. He paid the ultimate cost for me. My wretched, no good, evil left the truth. Lazarus, come forth. Sarah, come forth. Are you ready? Are you ready to confess your sins? Are you ready to come home? Are you ready? Got to stay back in that closet. Got to go back. No hope, no love. Misery, misery, misery. But guess what? I did it to myself. Had everything I needed right here. When you have the mercy of Jesus, when you know you don't deserve not an inch of his love, but he poured, poured baskets of love on you. You get up, shout it. You get up, get up, get up, get up, shout it. He came, he came, he came once again for me. I'm gonna wake you, I'm gonna wake you up again, once again, my daughter. That's not the way. Come this way. I have a brighter way. I have a brand new start for you. Do you want it? Do you want it? My path is straight. My path is right. And guess what? I can't take me on his path. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad to be. I'm glad, I'm glad, 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 I'm glad, glad. Are you happy to be in a place you can be set free? I am glad just to be here. I'm glad. It don't matter about the song. It's about your praise. Are you on the inside? God said, are you real? Did you come to praise me? Yeah. Yes, I did.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah. yeah. I call you all that.
I call you all that.
That's your name.
Your name is all.
You have been. Jesus, that's your name.
Your name is all,
all that you are,
all that you are,
and all that you'll be. Yeah.
Amen. Again, we thanking God for allowing us to be here. We thank God for our choir. We thank God for their director, Sister Makiba. Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord. Amen. Before I go with the message, we're going to have a special presentation at this time.
Good day, everyone. My name is Harmony Sneed. There are 66 books in the Bible, and two of them are named after women, and one of them is Esther. My Bible presentation is on the book of Esther. The book of Esther has a lot of life lessons for me and us to use in our relationship with God. God's providence, God's timing, and a tool for God. God's providence is when He guides, cares for, upholds the universe and all that occurs in it. He does this when He allows a young Jewish woman named Esther, who is around 14 years old, to be raised by her older cousin Mordecai as his own daughter after both her parents passed away. Thereafter, she was chosen to be queen, wife to King Ahasuerus. God's timing. God allowed Esther to be chosen as queen. She was the only one that could have approached the king to reverse the decree to have all the Jews killed. God's providence is seen when God places Esther and her older cousin Mordecai in a position to prevent the genocide of the Jews. Also in the book of Esther, God used an enemy to him as a tool for him.
Yes.
God also uses his enemies as a tool to fulfill the scriptures.
Yes.
He does this when he allows Haman to be hung on the gallows that he built for Mordecai, and Mordecai to replace Haman as second officer to the king, which prevented the genocide of the Jews.
Yes.
The king wrote another decree that would allow the Jews to be able to defend themselves by letting their attacker know that they can kill their wife and children as well in defending themselves.
Yes.
The king gave Mordecai his ring, and Mordecai made better decisions for everyone, including the Jews. The book of Esther has a lot of life lessons for me and us to use in our relationship with God.
Yes.
Mainly God's providence as a gentle reminder that God knows He has not forgotten His people and that He is still in control.
Yes.
And we thank God for her presentation. Amen.
Amen.
And she allowed us to know God is still in control.
Amen.
Amen. And we're thankful for that, because if He wasn't, we see the mess the world is in, what man has done. And then Lord knows you can look at how you did your own life and see the mess you made of that. But we thank God that He is in control, and we thank God for His providential care over wretched man. We thank God for her. It was what a wonderful presentation she made. God to continue to bless you. Amen. We thank God again for all of our children. We thank God for just allowing me and all of us to be here today. Thank God for His continuous care upon us. And we thank God for how He watches over us on a daily basis.
Sometimes you think you have things in control, but you'll find out through the Word of God, and I'm finding out as I'm going back and looking at my life, I had control over nothing. Absolutely, positively nothing. When I really look at it and get a glimpse of it, I don't see the fullness of it yet. I saw nothing but hopelessness. But I thank God for bringing me to a place of hope. It is something when you're in the world just adrift on the sea of ocean, the ocean of sin, and you get to the place where you're exhausted, but you know nobody that can help you. But somehow God, through his providential care, he caused a wind to blow. He caused a prayer to be prayed. When I was stuck in the bowels of Babylon, someone in Albany, Georgia prayed. Guess where I was? I was thousands of miles away in another time zone in a whole nother country. I was in Okinawa, Japan, in a small little camp called Camp Swab. But God rolled through the bowels of Babylon, and he broke off that rock that held me. He broke that hook that had me hooked. He broke tradition of family. Hey, glory to God. He broke a stronghold, and he caused me to come to Albany. When I came, my intentions was to do the last 4 years, of which I just reenlisted in Okinawa to do, and I was going back to drift at the sea of sin. I did not know he was here present, and he was alive in Albany, Georgia. The E Club, hear what I say now, the E Club on the Marine base, I met someone that knew a place that she can tell me about. But I tell you, thank you for this first. Before she told me about that place, she told me this as we were riding one day. She said, Brad, because I was saying I was saved because I had gotten baptized in Okinawa before I came to Albany. So I went deeper instead of coming out, deeper in sin. There's no way you can be saved not doing the things you and I are doing. Pride wanted me to fight. Pride wanted me to dispute and to stand up against what she said. But before I spoke, I'm telling you, the words look like God right here in my throat. Some of you have heard me refer to it as my bitter pill because I had to swallow my own words. Something told me to listen. And as I stopped and thought about what was said, I said within myself, that's right. And it caused me to no longer say that I was saved. It is something when you fool yourself because of the tradition of man and false religion tells you you're right with God. But I want to tell God, thank you. He brought me to a place that I've never been given no false hope. And I'm so grateful for what God has done. Amen. Those of you who are able, I'm going to ask you to stand at this time as we go before the throne of grace with a brief word of prayer. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, as I come, we come. We thank you, God, just for another day. I want to tell you thank you for what you've done for me. And God, what you've done for so many of us here in this room. You've given us a chance to come out of the sin in which we were in. And Father, as we go into your word today, I'm asking that you speak to our hearts and allow us to see the things that you would have us to see. We praise you. We thank you for all that you do. And God, if there's a soul here that needs to be saved, we ask in Jesus' name that you set them free. Do it for your honor and do it for your glory. In Jesus' mighty name I pray and I thank you. Amen. Amen. Turning your Bibles to Daniel chapter 4. Excuse me. Daniel chapter 4. Daniel chapter 4. We'll be reading verses 14 and 15. Daniel chapter 4. Verses 14 and 15. Daniel chapter 4, verses 14 and 15. Read from Carol.
He cried aloud and said thus, hew down the tree and cut off his branches, shake off his leaves, and scatter his fruit. Let the beast get away from under it, and the fowls from his branches. Nevertheless, leave the stump of his roots in the earth, even with the band of iron and brass, in the tender grass of the field, and let it be wet with the dew of heaven, and let his portion be with the beast in the grass of the earth.
Amen. We certainly tell God thank you for his word. And from those two verses of scripture there, my subject today in the form of a thought is a question again that you can ask to yourself, why I had to be chopped down. Why I had to be chopped down. I want to tell God thank you for his word. And I'm telling you, pride is a killer. Your own pride will cause you to go low. And your own pride goes before destruction. And your own pride causes you not to listen to sound instruction as it goes forth. Your own pride will elevate you to a place you have no business being. Your own pride will have you to make yourself an idol against God. Remember, it was said to us, and we've been taught, that an idol is anything in which we place before God, even ourselves. It does not have to be a wooden object or a statue of any kind, but anything that you place before God. Pride will cause you to think that you're entitled to things that you're not. Pride will drive a man low. Now, I came today with my word. Last week I gave it to you, but I wrote it down. And this is the word that our drill instructors used to often use against us. It says belligerent. Belligerent is defined as this: marked by readiness to fight or argue. Pride will bring that to you. Aggressive. And what I love was the sentence that they used to describe it as an adjective. It said, a bull-necked, belligerent old man. I said, now that says a lot in that statement that they use to identify it. A bull-necked, belligerent old man. When you're full of pride, you will not turn for nothing. It takes, it's like trying to push down a building when a person is full with pride. Thank you, Jesus. But I want to tell God, thank you, that I'm chopped down because I will not turn, I will not stop, I will not heed to good, sound instructions. Amen? And we're going to take a look at it in a few minutes. He said, he cried aloud and said thus, hew down the tree and cut off his branches, shake off his leaves and scatter his fruits. His fruit. Let the beast get away from under it and the fowls from his branches. God had to strip King Nebuchadnezzar of everything that he held on to himself as being important. And I want to tell God thank you for his stripping method. It's good to be stripped of God and broken at the same time. It's good when God can strip you and in stripping you show you you're nothing. You're nothing but mere man, and your breath is within your nostril. Then this is the blessed part. Nevertheless, leave the stump of his roots in the earth. I'm going to work with him. And if my method can't turn him, he won't be turned. But I want to tell God, thank you for the method that he used. He can take a belligerent man and cause him to be humble before the Almighty God. It says here, when I refuse to bend, bow, or break to God, he sometimes, if he can, allow hard things to crack us. When you make yourself that stiff stone, when you make yourself that stiff neck, you need something that can crack it to cause you to turn and to come to God's way. Now, nevertheless, leave the stump of his roots in the earth, even with a band of iron and brass, immediately was sure that he was going to bring him back to the person that he once was. And let his portion be with the beast in the grass of the earth. Go down to verse 17, and what does it say, verse 17?
This matter is by the decree of the watchers, and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will, and setteth up over it the basis of men.
I don't have a kingdom that I'm set up over, but God wants me to know he still rules, and he super rules. Amen? He said, this matter is by decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men. It is something when I forget or I think I rule things. That day as we rode, Sheila and I rode in that vehicle. And I'm going to go back, if you will, just to when I was in, before I came here. I had done my tour in Okinawa, and I came and I was home in Louisville. And I remember I was sitting in the living room. Everybody was gone. My sister had just recently came over to go to school. My brother and I, he was still there. We was in the apartments out on Southland Boulevard. And I remember watching this show. And I remember as I sat on that sofa, I felt such a hopelessness. I felt hopeless. And I remember the show that I was watching. At the end of it, this lady started singing this song. She said, maybe God is trying to tell you something, but when you're not familiar with his voice, how do you know he's talking? Huh? I've never heard nobody speak the oracles of God from his word to where I knew or had an understanding that God was talking. But I see why he had to chop me down. Because in religion, I had built myself up, and I didn't know I had built myself up to the point in which I did. But I'm so glad as I sat there and I felt that hopelessness and I heard the song sing, I remember I just cried. I cried. But I didn't know through his providence, he was bringing me to Albany, Georgia, so he can tell me and bring me to a place where I can hear his voice. I didn't know he was bringing me to Albany, Georgia, to a place that my life can be changed. None of us knew when we walked through the doors where we were coming into, but God had already arranged it for me to come here. It was by the watches and by his decree. It's why we're here. We're not here through no goodness of our own. God knew, nevertheless, that word nevertheless, as I looked up and said, as you know, it showed to me, God, you knew the hurt I would bring. You knew the disappointment I would have. You knew all of the betrayals I would cause. You would know all about how I wouldn't even be a husband in my own house. You knew how I wasn't there to bear the children along with my wife as she bared it and was burdened about them. But he still had a place set up just for me. And I want to tell him thank you. Because if he would not have brought me, I still would have been riding high on my way to hell. I still would have been thinking I'm something and I was nothing. I still would have been standing on the proud footsteps and foundation of false religion and on my way, slipping my way to the devil's hell. I remember as I meditated this week, I remember this, that Sunday in Lee County after the message went forth, I remembered as I stood there, that battle that went on and within my mind, those three questions. What are these people going to think? I remember the answer said, they also had to come. You just wasn't here to see it. And as I heard it, I looked. Then they also said, he said, wait till next week. And then I heard it say, tomorrow is not promised. And every time I heard the question and the right answer was given, I said, yes. And each time I said yes, I felt a freedom that I didn't have. I felt chains falling off me. I felt things pulling away from me. And the last one that could have really anchored me was this. What are your parents going to think? And the answer was, they also have to stand for themselves. And on that, I said, that's right. And it broke everything that held on to me. I was free to make a decision to come to Christ. I was free, and I saw, as I'm looking at you all now, I saw through my mind's eye, I saw a line, and I was in that line, and I was headed to hell. It let me know, you on your way to hell. And I made the decision that Sunday to come out, and I came up because I was so astonished. I finally was able to hear the voice of God. And God didn't tell me my name was M-A-N. He told me my name was Sinner. But in that, he freed me. You need to have the right label. And it needs to be given to you of God. Man told me as I was a teenager, I am M-A-N. That I, permission and license to sin. But that Sunday I heard that I was a sinner. My license to sin was revoked. And God was saying, make a decision for me. Do you want me in your life as Lord and Savior? As I stepped out from behind the pew, I felt something rush from my chest. But it wasn't, I didn't get salvation because of what rushed out of me and the feelings I had. I got it because I believe God by faith. That's the only way one can receive salvation. You can come to church and you can have chills run up and down your body. You can come to church and you can cry a river of tears. But if you never come to church and see yourself that sinner, lost, in need of a Savior, and receive Jesus Christ into your life by faith, you can never ever be saved. Why I had to be chopped down. It is something when you're stubborn. When you're stubborn, you fight authority. When you're stubborn, you fight divine authority. When you're stubborn, you're belligerent. When you're stubborn, you become defiant. When you're stubborn, you don't hear nothing. Because I know what is right for me. But God had worked with King Nebuchadnezzar on numerous occasions, and I can't look at him, but I got to look at me, and Lord, help us to look at us. How many times have God strived with you? How many times have God strived with me? Stop what you're doing. Get with people, and don't be with people like you. Get with those walking in the right direction. But you stubbornly said with your belligerent self, I'm not. You don't have to say it verbally. Your action speaks. When you don't change your behavior, God sees it and God is upset. It is something when God blesses you and brings you into a place where the portal, that exit for your soul, leads you to some steps that take you to heaven. But your belligerent, prideful attitude will cause you to tell God, I don't want your way. I want it my way. King Nebuchadnezzar was a prideful king. He was so prideful. I read some of the background on him. He was so that he was able to take life. Whom he wanted to kill, he killed. Whom he wanted to live, he lived. Had him to live. Whom he wanted to set up, he set up. Whom he wanted to take down, he took down. But God wanted him to know, you don't rule things. And we've come to church and our ugly attitudes try to change things. Our ugly attitude fight against the foundation that's here. Our ugly attitude caused a lot of misery and a lot of sleepless nights. But I'm thanking God. He laid the foundation. If it was laid by man, it would not have lasted. If it was laid by man, the Cuff family, probably being the biggest family, would have ruled the church. But God didn't let unrighteousness come in. He told the Cuff family, you must line up with my word. The Wright family, the Roberts family, all families, line up. I set this foundation. Somebody suffered for me. And you're not going to walk over what I have established. Hallelujah. And he allowed us to know, I don't care how close the bind is, you fall in line or else. I've never ever seen, heard, or any church where the leader has no respect to person.
Thank you, Jesus. The filth I came from. Hey, hallelujah. If you put in a big offering, they want to recognize you. But yet you got your girlfriend strutting. Here, it doesn't matter what you put in the offering plate. Be holy, for I am holy, is what they say. Follow me as I follow Christ. Hey, glory to God. Why I had to be chopped down? Because I wouldn't listen. Why I had to be chopped down? Because I was belligerent. Why I wouldn't have to be chopped down? Because I'm disrespectful. Thank you, Jesus. And it doesn't matter who it is, even in your own house. And God knows it's true. Somebody brought it out. Charity begins at home. And if you're not right there, Lord, helps us, help me, help us to get right there. In the name of Jesus. And Sheila, as I'm looking at your face, I got to say, forgive me for the wretched husband I've been. Hey, glory to God. And I would not even have known that except for the truth of God. Because the way I was before, I was patted and I was praised and I was lifted up. But here I've been chopped down. I'm so glad I've got chopped down. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It's a blessing to be chopped by God. And he can say, lead the band, lead the roots. I can work with him. Lead the roots, I can work with her. But if he say, chop it down and root it up, you on your way to hell, my friend. You on your way to hell. But if he can say, lead the roots, it's chopping time. Yet you hate being stripped of everything. But if stripping me causes me to know Jehovah rules, if stripping me causes me to have the right respect, strip me, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. This is a place where God is able to hold back demons, especially that demon of religion. And listen, you can become religious sitting right here in truth. And guess what? That's the worst kind. Because you're fooling yourself even against the knowledge of God through the scriptural truth of his word, that you can be as you so choose and God is going to excuse you. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, because I am still living, it does not mean God has glanced over my disrespect and pride. Huh? He have mercy in here. Because somebody else prays. He has mercy in here because somebody else don't want to see our souls end up in hell. He has mercy in here even against the most disrespectful spirit. He still works and pulls. He allows us to know God sees our heart. He allows us to know God sees us when we make those secret phone calls. God sees us as we look across the room to our buddy. And we don't tell our buddy they're wrong. Nor does our buddy tell us we're wrong for being in God's house so disrespectful. But God sees every act, every look, every thought, every imagination. He has a record of it. As he had a record of King Nebuchadnezzar. He strived with this man time and time again over different miracles that he's shown to show to him the place and the people that you have just captured, the Israelites. They are not an ordinary group of people. He showed to him a man that accepted every pagan god of every group that he invited and captured in his kingdom. He allowed them to establish their own pagan worship, and he, King Nebuchadnezzar, adopted their G-O-D-S, small g. He adopted their religion as his. But he had a problem with Jehovah. And his problem was his pride. Before you can accept Christ, you got to come down. Before you can accept Christ, you got to humble yourself.
before you can accept Christ, you got to accept, I'm the wretched man. I'm the culprit, not nobody else. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. And this another quick thing I wrote down as I was meditating. How do I know I'm prideful? It said, and this is what it said. If I go to my defense faster than I go to the defense of God and his people, I'm prideful. Do you hear it? How do I know I'm prideful? If I go to my defense faster than I go to the defense of God and his people, I'm full of pride.
Yes.
Because I'm making it about me.
Yes.
I'm full of pride because it's all about me.
Yes.
I'm full of pride because I'm telling you, I can't get wrong. How can a person that get wrong, and we in a body of flesh that gets wrong almost daily? We need our minds cleansed sometimes just from sitting down, not even watching, not on TV. Your mind will drift into something that you got to shake yourself from. And if you don't ask God to plead the blood of Jesus, it will take you on a zoo, on a roller coaster ride. And you will feel every last emotion of whatever filth it takes you to. But I want to tell you, I tell God, thank you.
Yes.
Strip me, chop me, everything that's needed, we needed to have it done.
Yes.
Why I had to be chopped down, I would not turn in spite of everything I saw.
Yes.
Nebuchadnezzar in chapter 2, we're not going there. In the chapter 2, Nebuchadnezzar had a dream. He called for his Chaldees and all the soothsayers. He forgot his own dream. And he told him, I need you to tell me the interpretation of this dream. They said, there's no way we can do it unless you tell us what has happened. And he made a decree. And this decree included Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He said, everyone that, thank you, Jesus, the soothsayers and all the different discerners, I set a decree that every last one of them be killed. And Daniel, they finally came. They were looking for Daniel and the other Hebrew boys to take them to murder them. And Daniel asked, why is such an urgency for this decree of the king? And they allowed it to be known to Daniel. Daniel told him, tell the king, give me a little bit more time. Daniel went before God, and God told Daniel the exact interpretation of the king's dream. It was through Daniel that the people was able to live. And we can be so disrespectful against the one who God uses to keep lies alone, keep us alive. Think about the disrespect. Think about the things you've walked over. Think about the looks you gave. Think about the things you said. Think about the actions you didn't even do that you were required to do. That too is disrespect. Thank you, Jesus. When Daniel gave the interpretation, Nebuchadnezzar began to say of a truth, different things he did, praising and trying to say the God that Daniel served was real. Let's bring it to Saints of God House of Worship. When I walked in the door, when I first came in, I couldn't hear the truth of the word of God. It went over my head because I was so full of religion. And I sat, God enabled me to sit in the midst, I'm saying for almost a year or so. And as I sat, I began to finally hear the word of God. And I realized, he's talking to me. He's telling me, that's how I am. He's saying, if I don't change, I'm gonna end up in hell. I began to hear in a way that I've never heard before. And what I'm trying to show you, God will show to us through personal experiences that he lives.
Yes.
He'll show to us through personal experiences.
Yes.
When we had not said a word to nobody about what's going on with us, someone will call you and say, I called just to tell you I love you.
Yes.
And that I love you lift you from the valley floor to the mountaintop.
Yes.
Someone will look at you and say, I want to pray for you.
Yes.
Someone will look at you and just give you words.
Yes. Right.
And in the words they give, and in the prayer that's prayed,
yes,
it addresses,
yes,
everything,
yes,
that's wrong with you.
Yes.
So what am I showing to,
yes,
us?
through personal experiences, God has tried to draw our attention, get it off our prideful self, and have us look to the hills from whence cometh our help. But when you're full of you, you won't let go. So you had to be stripped. Why I had to be stripped? Because you won't hear. You had to be stripped because for the many times you've fallen, and yet you forgave me. I say thank you. I want to tell God thank you. For the many times disrespect have gone forth, and he spared me to live, thank you. For the many times I didn't hear nor turn, thank you. I'm not dead and in my grave, so I got a chance to repent and get right with God. Hallelujah. It's a blessing when God can show you who you are. He strived with Nebuchadnezzar to show him, Nebuchadnezzar, you're not who you say you are. You're not who you think you are. The other occasion happened to be when he built that graven image. He built that fiery furnace. He threw had the three Hebrew boys thrown in it. This is chapter 3. And as he did, he had the furnace heated 7 times hotter than it was. The word of God tells us those strong men that took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the flames killed them outside the furnace. But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego fell down in the burning furnace. And then they was loose. And the king said this, did we not, to his counselors, did we not throw, paraphrasing of course, three men in this furnace? They said, yes, O king, we did. Then he said, I see 4 men walking around in the furnace, and the 4th one looks like the Son of God. What I'm trying to show you, God, through many miraculous acts, have shown to us this is no ordinary ministry. Huh? What can cause a fornicator to stop fornicating and be content? Huh? I've experienced that myself when I went to Okinawa. I was told, when you go, if you live right, when you return, you will have the joy that you wanted. So glory. See there, no respect to person. As I went to Okinawa, I was able each night to go back to my room and go to sleep. And when I went to sleep, I said, Lord, help me with my dreams. Because Lord knows while you're sleeping, things and thoughts can come to you. And he kept me the times that I was overseas. And I came back and I had joy unspeakable and full of God's glory because he did it. I've tried to keep myself, and I failed. I tried to stop things and I couldn't. So what I'm showing to you and telling to you, we have to be stripped, because when you walk over everything and you continue to walk over everything, God sees you and he's saying, I'm gonna get you. And I would rather be stripped now than to stand before his throne and to find out and he say, depart from me, because you never got things right. It's time to get right. This is the dressing up room down here. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Go now. We're going to flip. Go to chapter 3 for me and read verse 25. This is what I just stated.
He answered and said, lo, I see 4 men loose walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the 4th is like the Son of God.
Amen. Amen. Thank God for his word there. Now, another thing, when one walks in pride, one of the hardest lessons to learn is that it is not about you. Amen? But God, and you can't control nothing. I found that out. It's not about me. It's about God. And it's about who he has set up. But pride will cause you to think it's all about you. Pride will fool you into thinking, I control things. But we control absolutely, positively nothing, because it's all about God. When I refuse to bend, bow, or break to God, he sometimes, if he can, allow hard things to break us. And it's a blessing to be broken by God. Amen?
Thank you, Jesus. I will go to verse 28. Go down to verse 28 here. In verse chapter 3, verse 28, excuse me.
Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and delivered his servants that trusted in him, and have changed the king's word and yielded their bodies, that they might not serve nor worship any god except their own God.
You see the difference in the letter in G, small g, capital G. I want to tell God, thank you for this. As I was meditating, Nebuchadnezzar was the king over Babylon, the literal country. God brought me out of the spiritual Babylon, this religious world. Both him as king and Babylon, they are mighty and strong. But Jehovah is stronger. And it's through him my soul has been set free. And it's through him that souls are set free. The word of God tells us this. Everyone that is proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord. Though hand join in hand, he shall not be unpunished. You can get with those like you, and you can try to give yourself strength. But God is saying, I see you, and I am the one that you got to stand before on the day of judgment. Proud means literally high. The same words describe that high look and a proud spirit. All of these imply arrogance, thinking oneself better than anyone, including God. You wouldn't think pride would take you there. But when you're blind to yourself, you don't know how far you go. When you won't listen to instructions, you don't know the spot that you're in. When you don't listen to instructions, you don't know how much trouble your soul is in with God. But I want to tell God, thank you, that he had a reason for stripping and chopping us down. And I'm glad that he did just that. Let's go to Psalms 83 and 18 in my closing. Psalms 83 and verse 18. For the many times I've fallen, and you forgave me. For the many times disrespect came forth, and you forgave me. Talking about Jehovah forgave me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So grateful for God. Amen. Psalms 83 and verse 18. And this is what God wants in stripping us and chopping us down, want us to know. Verse 18. Psalms 83, verse 18. Read it for me, Carolyn.
That men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, art the most high over all the earth.
It's not about me. It's not about you. It's about God. Amen. That men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, art the most high over all the earth. I'm so glad that my orders for duty preference came true. I'm so glad God brought me to Albany, Georgia. I would tell people when I was in the Marine Corps, I would say, the best duty station I had was Albany, Georgia. And it wasn't good because I found my wife. It was good because I found Jesus. It was good because of him. It was good because I did not leave this place the way I came. I came here a sinner. Sins above my head. But I found out Jehovah rules. And I want to tell him thank you that he satisfied my longing soul. If God has been able to speak to your heart, he's shown to you you need his salvation. He's shown to you you need to come and let him do for you what you can't do for yourself. Why don't you come as we stand to our feet, and we're going to ask the choir to give us a song.
Can help you.
So we tell God, thank you again for what he's done. Thank God for his word. Thank God for him keeping us another day. And as our brothers come, let us act in accordance.
Why do you seek the living? He is risen, just as he said. Why do you seek the living? My Lord is risen, just as he said. Oh, the stone
is thrown away.
Jesus is gone. Come and look. He's already gone. Oh, the stone. Jesus is gone. Come and look. He's already gone. Why do you seek the living? He is risen, just as he said. Why do you seek the living? My Lord is risen, just as he said.
The battle's fought, the victory's won. Jesus did it,
it's already done.
He conquered death, he conquered hell. He gave me joy, and now I can tell.
Why do you seek the living?
He is risen,
just as he said. Why do you seek the living? My Lord is risen, just as he said.
The battle's fought, the victory's won. Jesus did it, it's already done.
Yeah.
He conquered death, he conquered hell. He gave me joy, and now I can tell.
Why do you see the living? He is risen, just as he said.
Why do you seek
the living? My God is risen, just as he said. Jesus lives, Jesus lives, woo! Jesus lives, oh yes, oh, he lives. Do you know God lives? Woo! I know he lives, oh yeah. Truth is tough, and eyes are being tough. shelter from the storm. My God keeps me in his arms. Yes. Do you know God lives? Do you know God lives? Oh God, he lives. Oh yeah. Oh, he lives. Oh God, he lives. Do you know God lives? Oh yeah.
Yes, he lives. I said, I know God lives. I know God lives. I said, I know God lives. Oh yes. He can cut down pride. He cut down pride. He can cut down pride. Oh yes. Lord, cut me down. Lord, cut me down. They cut me down. Oh yes.
Came to the bank. My true messenger, I am here, cause a true messenger, he lived. He told me that I was no good. I'm no good. Yes,
he lived.
He kept my life. He kept my life. He kept my life. Oh
yes,
with his power. With his power, oh yes,
he brought me out. He brought me out. He brought me out. Yes, he said, stay out. He said, stay out. He said, stay out. Yes,
I'm glad he lives. Oh, you're glad. Because he lives, Lord, thank you for living. That's why I'm alive. He has blessed my life, and I'm glad about it. Oh, he lives. Do you know God lives? Do you know God lives? Oh, yeah. He let me repent. He let me repent. He let me repent. Oh, yeah. Jesus lives, oh yeah. Oh, the storm, Jesus is gone. Come and look, he's already gone. Oh, the storm, Jesus is gone. Come and look, he's already gone. Why do you seek the living? Just as he said, why do you seek the living? My glory is risen, just as, just as he said. Hallelujah.